Can I eat the clean part of moldy bread? Is it okay to just take the moldy part off? Is it safe to eat anyway as is? In this video, you'll learn whether or not you can still salvage your moldy bread. So stay tuned until the end. Make sure to also visit and browse the Arsenal Aspires website to find hundreds of different health products to suit your individual health goals. You'll find the best products for your body, mind, and spirit. You can also see a list of some of the greatest books online that I've come across, and my blog is there too if you want to check that out. Hey guys, it's Ian Arsenal. I'm back here with another video where we continue this series of health and wellness topics this channel explores. It's been a while since I posted, so I apologize. I haven't been consistent enough as I've had a lot on my plate lately, but I'll try to keep But I'll try my best to keep consistent, as some of you have been leaving a lot of positive feedback from my videos, which I'm so grateful for, to be able to help make your day that much better. If you haven't already subscribed, it would mean the world to me if you did that real quick, as I'm trying to bring as much quality health information as I can for you guys. Also, if you like the video, please do give it a like, as it would seriously make my day. Anyways, let's get this video started. Moldy bread can become a heated topic in some households, as some argue that it's perfectly fine to eat, but is it? Let's first start off by addressing why on earth your bread becomes polka dotted with green spots. Mold is a fungus in the same family as mushrooms. No, not those ones. The types you have usually are Aspergillus, Penicillium, Fusarium, Mucor, and Rhizopus. They survive by breaking down and absorbing the nutrients of the bread, which causes these fungi to grow. Why are they hairy though? The fuzzy part are actually the colonies of spores, which is how the fungus reproduces. These spores can travel through the air inside your bread package and grow in other areas, hence explaining the polka dots. So mold is safe to eat, which is why people think the mold on bread is safe to eat as well, which I'll come back to in a bit. The mold on blue cheese or gorgonzola is okay to eat because it's usually a harmless fungi that causes it. But because it's impossible to know what kind of mold is growing on your bread just by looking at it, it's best to assume it's harmful and not eat it at all. Further than this, you also want to avoid smelling molded bread too, as you may inhale the spores, especially if you have an allergy to mold, as this can trigger your asthma or lead to other breathing problems down the road. In rare cases, life-threatening anaphylaxis could occur, especially for those who have allergies to inhaled mold. What if I just take the molded part off though? Marianne Gravely, a senior technical information specialist for the United States Department of Agriculture, says we don't recommend cutting mold off of bread because it's a soft food. What she meant is that you and I only see a few spots on the fungus. The microscopic roots of the fungus can spread quickly, as bread is very porous, leaving those openings for the mold to actually spread through the bread. The spread of mold is further than the eye can see, which is why you should not try to scrape it off or salvage the rest of your loaf. What hits this home is because mold can produce harmful and invisible poisons called mycotoxins, which spread quickly, especially if the mold's growth is heavier. The more mycotoxins you ingest, this can eventually lead to digestive issues and other illnesses too. This can also harm your pets if they get in touch with them, so please, please do me a favor and don't give spoiled bread to your animals because they could get sick. I'm an animal lover, what can I say, but if you are one too, I hope that you subscribe and love animals. Mycotoxins really suck because they have their way of altering the healthy bacteria in your gut. Long-term exposure to them, especially if you're dealing with alpha toxin produced by a certain species of Aspergillus, has been linked to an increased cancer risk. So how long is bread really good for then? If you can't see the mold at all times, how do we not know that our bread has already gone bad? Well, it depends on the type of bread, right? Mold grows on gluten-free bread faster as it has more moisture and very little chemical preservatives, making it a great place for fungi to have fun. I know, bad joke, right? This is why you see it sold frozen sometimes. You may also have noticed it, that the bread is vacuum sealed instead of preservatives. This is convenient as it removes oxygen, which is needed for mold to grow. So no oxygen means that no mold can grow. But remember, it can still be contaminated after the package is opened. But generally speaking, without preservatives, the shelf life of bread stored at room temperature is generally 3 to 4 days. Of course, with preservatives, it may deter mold growth, which can give you an extra few days. You might be then asking, what are some tips to prevent mold growth? Number one, keep it dry. If you see the packaging wet, dry it up as it will prevent mold growth. Number two, cover it. This will protect it from the spores that are in the air. Number three, freeze it. Refrigerating it can make it dry, but freezing it slows the growth without ruining the texture as much. I hope this video has helped bring attention and clarify the harms of eating moldy bread. If this video has helped you in any way and you enjoyed it, please do give me a like, letting me know what your thoughts are. Also, let me know in the comments below how you keep your bread fresh or the kinds of breads that you recommend. I love bread, and if you love it too, write down in the comments, I love bread in all caps. And until then, see you on the next one. Thank you so much for sticking all the way to the end of this video. Make sure you hit that subscribe, like, and notification icons for more videos like these. Until then, see you on the next one.